stretch until the numbers came back. Found love, we ain't playing. We're trying to hit my dope like my hand like this. We don't listen, but all the smoke will call saying, you know, you pissed me with some petty. Your head be straight. Yeah.
Yo, welcome back to the William Nick Center, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers of Prairie View Indian University getting ready to take on arch rival Texas Southern, the Battle of 290, the Battle of Texas, the Texas Shootout, whatever you want to call it. It's going to be fantastic out here. The Lady Panthers got it done early, defeating the Lady Tigers of Texas Southern by a score of 78-65. Ryan Payne led all scores with 21 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists. Amari Williams snatched down 9 rebounds. Jessica Soders had 7. Adriana Waddle had 6. And Desiree Lewis had 5 rebounds. Joining me is Athletic Director Anton Goff. AD, man, I tell you, man, this Panther team is really starting to feel its groove and getting in its niche. I tell you, what a great game by the women today.
Yeah, no, Ryan Payne, she played a heck of a game, man. 21 points and, like, the things that she does on the court for us, not just the scoring but for leadership, is incredible, man. She distributes, she rebounds when she needs to, and she defends.
Yeah, we've got a bright future for our team. We've got some people that can really get it done. Ryan Payne, the impact player of the week last week, 22 points per game, 4 rebounds, 4 assist and a block shot, came right there on it again today. She's going to be a superstar. She definitely is going to be one of the superlatives at the end of the year. This team is starting to really gel together. They're really starting to find their niche. And what Coach Pugh told us was that they are a rhythm team.
Yeah.
And when they get in the rhythm, they can play. You could tell a couple of times they got out of sync.
Yeah.
Coach Pugh, man, I tell you, she's the best. She called them down, called them over, calmed them down. And then they got back to playing Panther basketball. This is just what we need as we get ready to take the road. We want to be 6-3, leaving, going on the road. And we're going to be right in the thick of it.
And this game was really important for us as, you know, it's a rivalry. But for the standings, it's important.
Oh, absolutely.
And like you said, you know, Ryan Payne, you know, this is her first year here. And she's trying to find her way to get everybody involved. And, you know, we got some older young ladies that are starting to gel together. Because, you know, this transfer portal, people are coming in, going out, and, you know, you got to put a team together, right? We can have some of the greatest players, but they need to play as a team, and you're seeing that now. These last couple games, they're doing some great things, and I'm looking forward to it.
Well, just like a broadcast team, you got to have some chemistry,
absolutely.
And it takes a little time to develop that chemistry when you meet new people.
Yeah.
Well, for some reason, you and I's chemistry just
jumped
right off.
From day one. I know you want me to retire as the AD and just come full time.
Let's do it. Matter of fact, you can work part time. But I tell you, man, it's been great having someone so involved in it. You know, the athletic director to come. And you've got a lot of energy. You got some youthful energy that we want to see as alums and Panther faithful.
Appreciate that.
Really, really fortunate to have this guy. We're putting together some initiatives to raise money at Prairie View. We told you, man, it takes money to run a program. So a lot of people that were calling and asking for tickets. I don't have as many friends as I did. Because, look at, man, the AD I'm playing. The days of, you know, just coming and enjoying are over. You got to support. You got to start putting your dollars in.
Buy a ticket.
We want to know what we need to do. If you got some issues, just email us at the university. You can always email Coach Pete. Go to the website and pick your choice. If you'd like to email the AD, you can. Senior Women Administrator and number 2, Alicia Pete.
Yep.
You can email Ms. Thurston.
Hey,
Mr.
So check this out. We're gonna come out with something in the next, probably this week,
okay,
where some people can email me, ask some questions, and some regular updates, and we're going to talk about a little fundraising. I did a little video, so we're going to send that out there in a little bit, and it's going to be out there.
A new video?
A brand new video. We just shot it Friday, so we got to put it all together so we can get it out there. But it's a combination of a little bit of, hey, this is how you can fundraise. This is what we've been doing this in the five months that I've been here. And this is where you can go if you want to ask some questions straight to the AD.
Hey, ask the AD. Coming your way. All you got to do is get online. They'll tell you what to do. Ask the AD. I kind of like that.
Yeah.
I like that. Well, the men's team, after just a superb performance on Saturday night, Monday night, really got to get it going here. We got to get up in our standings. They're 5-3. We're 3-4. We're not out of this thing yet. We've got to start now.
This is a huge game for us. We need to be able to move up. We're right on the cusp at that 9 spot. Where we got to get at least 8 or higher so we can get into the tournament for the SWAT. And this game is a long way going. If we win this, then we can get that streak going. You know what I'm saying?
And you've got a few more opportunities. You got Jackson, Mississippi Valley. You've got Pine Bluff coming in. And then you got Southern Grambling. That's always a big weekend to wrap up the season as we get ready to go. I think the Panthers can get ready and do it, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Well, we're about to get this one underway. Starting for Texas Southern, Jamar Young, the senior from Dallas, Texas. P.J. Henry, we know about him. He's from right there in Houston, Texas, starting to guard. Starting at the other guard is going to be Deion Stroud, a junior from Fresno, California. Coach Jones likes to run a three-guard spread, and the Panthers will get it to start it off here in the early going, and Hopkins will have it.
Great tip.
Hopkins will get it over to, is that McKinley, who has started for the Panthers? Is that 33, McKinley Harris? All right. Talk to his dad on Monday night after the game. Miles with a long three-pointer, no good. It's snatched down by the Tigers, and here we go.
That's a good shot, though.
19-38 left to play. We're just getting this one underway, folks. If you've just checked in, here we go. Right side. Henry gives it left to Young.
Ooh, that was close to a travel.
Young back out now to Chase. Chase bringing on the right side. Stop with a floater from 15. Puts it in for two. Is that 11? That's Jonathan Sissy.
Yeah. We've got to use our quickness. They're a little taller than us, but I think we're a little faster than them, so we've got to use our quickness to take advantage.
Hopkins with a running floater to the goal off the glass for two. Penetrate, dribble, drive.
I don't think these guys can stay in front of our guards, so we've got to take advantage of that and not settle for shots.
We've got a tandem of very, very quick guards, as AD said, and they're going to give fits to Texas Southern. A little five-footer from Deion Stroud. He'll get his read and put it back up there. 4-2 now. We're going back the other way. Charles Smith, the fourth, is trailing, coming down, getting on the block. Hopkins finds another hole, gets somebody else on his hip. He's fouled, no call with the body. We're going back the other way. Here comes CC. Kicks a 7 to Stroud. Thought about it, now he'll kick it back out.
That was a lot of body on that play right there.
Carter. Grayson Carter there, and Smith on the back there of Jamar Young. Both guys jumping up.
Initially he had it, but then he got a little too aggressive.
Well, if you look at the replay, here's the shot. Down low. And Smith. Smith kind of grabbed him around the shoulder there. Kept it on the ground, though. That was a smart play. No foul shot. 4-2, the Tigers up 2. And a packed crowd here in the Baby Dome. If you're not here, well, golly gee.
Yeah, it's sold out.
Your bad.
Yeah.
Round long three-pointer now from Grayson Carter. Stroud gets the rebound and puts it back up. Check that. That's Young, number 2. I thought it was 7. Horton comes right side. Hopkins is yet to get involved. Horton now standing at the top of the key looking right side. Miles set the picks. He brings it right wing looking in the corner. McKinley Harris warming up, shooting that three-point shot from that corner every game day before the game. Hopkins, man, he is so quick. They put it back up there. Harris trying to get it up. No. Miles and Harris on the blocks for the Panthers. Can't find the hole. The Tigers by 4, 6-2, CC.
That was the height advantage for them right there on that one. We got it inside, just couldn't finish it because got bothered by the height.
See, you got to cut him off there. Hopkins standing there on that right side waiting on his man, but he's got to – he's trying to defend that three-point line over there, so he let him fly on by. Here we go in the middle. Brian Miles now takes it right on the right block, puts it up off the glass. No, comes in and out too hard. And 18.
Once again, there was
a lot
of contact there. I mean, if they're going to let him play, they got to let him play on both sides.
Three-point attempt. Left side from P.J. Henry. We know P.J. Henry can shoot that three-point shot.
Yeah.
So we're going to have to defend him. Is that 33 getting them, or is that 3? Okay, McKinley Harris picking up the first foul. Nimmer will come in for Prairie View.
Justin Nimmer. Foul on Harris on that one.
Nimmer comes out to get it out to Young. Now back over to P.J. Henry. looking back over to Young. He puts it off the glass. No foul. Call. They're going to call a block and foul. Oh, man, wow.
That was close.
Is that on 12? Are they going to call it on Horton?
He was moving, but, I mean, he ran right through him.
That's going to be first one on Horton up off the bench. Here comes Lane. Charles Lane Jr.
We've got to get some stops here. Like, we've got to figure out their size and how not to foul.
Well, Byron calm, cool, and collected on the bench, just kind of letting them get their legs, so to speak. Nunley, the menacing guard, will come in there. Man, Nunley is like a pesky mosquito.
So you said calm, cool, and collected. That's one. Those are three words I never use to describe Coach Smith.
No, but look at him. That's why. Yeah. I'm just excited, yeah. Intense, yeah. Exhilarating. Yeah. We can just
absolutely
go on and on.
Yeah.
Second shot is way it's good. Well, yeah. First shot, no good. Second shot, good. 9-2, 7-point edge. Here comes Nunley. Hopkins.
This is an important possession right here. We need a score.
Smith down low. Gets it over to Adebrian Miles. Miles turns, twists, gets him up on his hip, up and under.
Ooh.
Yeah. You called it.
That's a great play right there. That's what you call footwork. Reminds me of Olajuwon back in the day. You're too young to know about Olajuwon.
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Coach. Left side, Lane has it. Pardon me, Henry. Coming around the right side, looking for Young. Can't find him to get it down low. Nice. See, defense
good
there
defense.
By Nunley, man.
Defense.
Nunley is just
he's
intense.
Aggressive. Yes, he's aggressive on D. Like, he goes after a lot of balls, and he gets his hands on a lot of balls. Deflections.
Stroud to take it out, throws it in. Sissy. Comes up. Oh, man, takes Nunley to the hoop with a left hand. And the Tigers up 11-4 now. Lane for three. No.
It's a tough shot right there.
And Horton steals it away. Lane back there. Give it to him. No, he's going to travel. Yeah, he picks up some Samsonite. But Smith is hanging around the wing over here. And that's going to be the first media timeout. The Panthers are starting slow here, but no need to fret, ladies and gentlemen. No need to fret.
Just 7 points.
The
it's
Panthers
early.
Trying to get it going here in the early going, folks. Stick around. This is exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Charles Porter and Athletic Director Anton Goff coming to you live courtside. Man, this is starting to be too easy for you and I, Dave, AD.
Yeah.
We've got so many comments on all of our social media platforms, and we sincerely thank you for our comments. AD, we went from 1,100 to 1,200 views last semester to 4,000 views for Monday and Saturday's game. We're at 4,000, and we thank you so much, fans. Continue to share,
absolutely,
share, and continue to enjoy exciting Panther sports right here on the Prairie View and then Panther Sports Network. 13-14, the score. Easy shot by Stroud there on the other side. Now Nunley will run the point for the Panthers. Brings it right side. He's no stranger to the point. Had to run it at the early going when Horton and Hopkins were hurt in the early preseason. Here comes Lane now. Puts it up. No. The Panthers just a little cold from the field. And now here comes the jacket off.
We talked about, ooh.
Ooh. CeCe just goes around.
That's Nutley. You got to give credit where credit's due. That was a good shot right there.
Yeah, McGaskey's going to come up off the bench there. Lane thought about it in the corner. Nutley back to Lane. Thought about it. Stops from 20. Gives it on the corner to Nutley. Out to Miles for three. And Miles can hit Nutley in the land of the Giants. Puts it up off the backboard. Oh. He's fouled. No call. And we're going back the other way. Golly gee. 15-14.
I don't know about that one.
A 15-4. And travel. He stepped on the line. And we'll go back the other way. That's a bailout call there. Make a call from this end there. Golly.
Basically, yeah. I mean, Nutley definitely got fouled on that last play. They got to blow the whistle on that.
Here's the play now. Brings it back down. And he steps on the line right there.
Yeah.
Here we go back now to on our end, 15-14.
Oh.
I mean, 15-4, pardon
me. And you got Nick in, number 11, Calais. He didn't even – he got to shoot that, though. That's why he's in the game.
Yeah, on the baseline, kicks it back out to Horton.
That's why he's in
the
game.
You got to give it up,
He's got to shoot that ball right there. See, he didn't even play last game, and I don't know if a lot of people know that. He didn't play last game.
No, he did.
So he's in now. He's a three-point shooter.
He's got to stop, spot, and shoot. He's good. That's what we brought him in for, that spot-up three-point shooting.
It was wide open. He's got to take that. I know he just got in the game, but, hey, you know what? There's such thing as being like the microwave. You got
to
go.
We're not pulling any punches.
Nah.
14-13. High off the backboard there was P.J. Henry. And now the Tigers starting to put it to the Panthers here. 13-point edge. Gazelius on the wing. Waiting in the corner. Here comes Hopkins over now to Horton. Horton puts it up. It's a mad scuffle for it. And the Tigers come up with it. Jump ball. And it'll go back the other way. Man, the Panthers.
A lot of sloppiness. They're going too fast. You know, we talked about rhythm before. They're definitely not in rhythm.
Not in sync at all. Smith will come out. Gazelius will come and take a seat. The Panthers just need to settle down. Where's your general on the court? Somebody's got to settle the guys down and get it going. And it should be Hopkins, the point guard.
He can't be out of control. If he's out of control, the team's out of control.
Absolutely. Hopkins is the point. Horton is the shooter. You got Lane over there on the three to shoot the ball. And then you got Miles down low. So you got a three-guard rotation. This is your fast break group right here.
Yeah. You got to get some stops on defense.
Henry brings it up top. Gives it now to over to Hunter. Hunter throws it away.
Turnover. Finally.
And here come the Panthers.
Just go up.
Ooh. Hunter with the block. Now here comes Charles Smith, right side. Now, Miles loses it, and the Tigers and P.J. Henry loses it again. It snaps back down, by Grayson Carter. And Carter will take a three-point shot. Hits the front of the iron, no good. Here come the Panthers. The Panthers on the fast break. Horton over to Hopkins. Hopkins or Horton, rather.
You got to get a better pass than that so you can shoot that. It's a lackadaisical pass on there. That's a foul, ref. Oh.
Horton back out to Miles. Miles working right side. Throws it over there to the Sigmas. They're not even in the game, but it was tipped.
It was tipped.
It was tipped by P.J. Henry, and here comes Lane for Nunley. And for the Tigers, Jalen Weisinger will check in for P.J. Henry. Weisinger, junior from right there in Houston, Texas. Also checking back into the game is Jamar Young, the senior from Dallas, Texas. 12:41 left to play here in the first. Thanks for sitting in for Coach Evans. Danny Evans were supposed to sit in with us, but the AD says, hey, I like this, and I'm away from all of that confusion over there. Here comes Lane on the baseline. Puts it up with a double pump. He's fouled. And it'll go to the line.
Danny's probably still celebrating.
He's probably still. That was a huge win for them because it gets them one step closer to what we talked about. The Panthers want to leave the Dome 6-3.
Yeah.
And if we can do that, we're right back in the thick of things. We're in the thick of things now.
Absolutely.
So to speak. But we want to have that extra game.
Smith. And it's a rivalry. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, absolutely.
Anytime you can beat your rival, whether it's TSU and Prairie View or Michigan State.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? You got Duke, North Carolina tonight. It's a rivalry. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I tell
good
you this.
When you beat your rival.
It's not going to be much fun going back down to the H&PE arena.
Wow.
It's going to be packed in there. That's okay. We got to get our win and get it here.
Exactly. You got to protect your house.
Traditionally, it's a win and win. You know, I don't think there have been too many sweeps in the last, 39 years I've been doing this.
Is that right?
Not too many sweeps.
Well, I don't like to lose, so.
Me neither. Kobe Granger.
I don't like splits.
Kobe Granger is going to check in for the Tigers, the son of athletic director Kobe Granger. If you didn't know, Kevin Granger, all-star point guard at Texas Southern University during the Robert Moreland days. I remember that. Oh, and a running jumper from Weisinger off of Horton. Or they're going to give it to Hopkins, 1-4? No, 1-2. Okay, that's right, off of Horton. You got to be careful with Horton and Hopkins because they kind of look alike, 12 and 14.
Yeah, exactly.
You know.
Well, see, his problem that time he went underneath the screen instead of over it. As soon as he went underneath, the dribbler had the angle on him.
Weisinger hits the back of the iron, a lane violation from Miles. They're going to say, well, Miles is saying Hunter left first. And
can't make those mental mistakes.
Yeah, Joe Wilbert III, Winston Trotter, and Jean-Pierre Jopin are out there as the officials.
You're down 13. You got a small margin of error. You can't make those mental mistakes like that.
Shot is away. It's good. Well, 20 to 6.
Yeah,
14-point lead. We got to do something here. Horton coming around. Miles sets the pick. Horton with a reverse spin. And 3 seconds, or is it going to be?
No, they got to push.
Okay, they're going to call that one on Weisinger. Away from the ball, the Panthers will get it. Where do the penalties look like here? 4 fouls for the Panthers, 2 for Texas Southern.
Yeah, they pushed him on a spin move in the lane.
Miles turns, twists, up and under. It's good for 2.
Great,
let's keep giving
footwork.
It to him.
Great footwork.
Let's keep giving it to him.
Yeah. See, he's getting the ball, and he's slowing the pace down, and he's making.
Nobody's blocking out that left baseline there. Kenny Hunter, the junior from Shreveport, Louisiana, with an easy one.
You can't allow the penetration in the lane. Then everything, your defense breaks down when you allow the penetration that deep in the lane.
Wow.
And we've got to watch our passing in the corner, wide open. Lane up and under is good for 2. Get him on the hip.
He gathers himself, and he makes a strong power move.
And I don't think Mr. Johnny Jones liked that one. He says, hey, the Panthers are starting to get up a little lather. We don't want them to get any lather here, ladies and gentlemen. 22 to 10 to score, a 12-point lead for the Tigers of Texas Southern. Stick around. We'll take a break and come back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View and M Panthers Sports Network.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G? And as a proud sponsor of HBCUs.
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
11:33 left to play here. In the first half, Charles Porter, AD, Anton Goff. Man, I'm privileged today. I got a whole 10 minutes of AD here for play-by-play in color. Yeah. 11:33 left to play, 22-10 the score. As you said, the Panthers need to slow down a little bit, gather them themselves, and go ahead and play.
Well,
make
the
plays.
You got to get some stops, though, too. You got to play some defense. Because here's the deal. Like, sometimes your shot doesn't fall, but that shouldn't affect the effort of your defense, right? And so we've got to continue to play. We've got to step our defense up a little bit so we can get some stops, maybe get some transition, because we are so fast. I think we can beat them in transition.
Well, we're having problems with points in the paint. We're just getting dominated in the paint here in the first half, 18-8 in the paint, we're five better rebounds as TSU than us. So
I don't know about that call right there.
I don't either. We had
both hands on the ball.
Well, here you go, two hands on the ball.
Yeah. Man, it could have been called a travel.
Panthers now with five fouls, getting in on the right side. Here comes Young to put it back in for an easy one. No, that's another point in the paint. That's 20 points in the paint. The Panthers are not blocking out.
Being killed on the boards.
Hopkins now the lane left side. Over to Kevin McGaskey. McGaskey out to McKinley. Harris out to Hopkins.
Wow. Little air ball there. He's got to get some confidence in the shot.
Charles Smith will check in for McKinley Harris. I talked to Mr. Harris, McKinley Harris's dad, after the game on Monday. He's a little despondent about not hitting any points, but he's out here shooting that three-point shot early every game day. And I told him, your time is going to come.
Absolutely.
And you're going to hit that big shot. The Tigers trying to skip it down low. Gets it behind Miles. Miles, why did you commit that foul? He had beat you on the block. Don't foul him from behind, son. Golly gee. I mean, hey, you're not going to win everyone.
Nah, you can't make these
mistakes.
That's
a frustration foul.
Yeah.
Six fouls now. Got him on the floor. That'll give him a fresh 20.
So Coach Smith isn't so calm, cool, and collected right now.
No three C's for him. It's Mad Matter Mattis. That's the three M's. Here we go, right side. Oh, here comes Charles Smith.
Great steal. Oh, here comes our guy.
Here comes Danny Evans.
Here comes Danny. He's done now, celebrating.
And now you got to go to work.
Hey, so should I get his salary for stepping in for him?
Yeah, absolutely. I won't have. Hopkins, back up top, coming right side. AD, thanks a lot. We've got some things to talk about. If you could come after halftime so we can discuss some of the events coming up. We do have National Signing Day coming up this February the 7th. I know we got some action going, but while we got AD, we got to get this one in. National Signing Day is coming up February 7th, 11:10, West Airport in Stafford, Texas. Yep. You can get all of the ticket information on our website. Also,
co-hosted by PV Alumni Affairs.
Yeah, that's right. PV Alumni Affairs, Miss Phyllis Darden Caldwell has been a great job with Alumni Affairs. Carla King, MC, one of my guys, will be out there helping out. We're going to come back and do some stuff on Splendid Media and try to make sure it's streamed and try to get 10,567 views. McCaskey back up top right side. Here comes Charles Smith. Smith from the left side on the block will be fouled and stopped. And that's going to be three on the Tigers. Also, man, we've had some superlatives for the softball season that's coming up. You know, the Panthers trying to repeat 3-3. Three on first team and three on the second team. And we'll get that graphic up in just a second. Yeah. Miles with the spins on the left
softball's
side.
Softball's on the quest for three in a row.
Lane finally hits
great
one. And that
shot
might be what he needs for
that's
his confidence.
Needed. Yes, we needed that to get out the snide.
Maya, go get it. Nunez, Viviana Figueroa, and Massey are the three first teamers. And then I think Jericho Rojas is on the second team. Aaron Talley and Destiny Smith are on the third team. Ooh, I got a pretty good memory there. Those are my girls, though, man. We went all the way to Baton Rouge, all the way to Mississippi together. And I tell you, it was a fun time, and they're coming back with more. 9:31 left to play. A foul on the floor. Again, the Panthers, man, just out of sync. Silly fouls, just kind of throwing their body all the way around. And Byron.
Yeah, I would love to see a replay on that, because I'm not sure if he actually hit him or not.
Okay, Byron is going to get a tech between this guy and this guy, because you know what he's gonna say because both of them are light-skinned. That's his deal. He's gonna say, we're both light-skinned and we're gonna fuss and watch and see. Here we go. Perry, PJ Henry,
the first one hits the second one,
man. How you get on, you know, come on, man. I was trying to get the replay there to see, but 3-point
it's all
shot.
Good. I'm not sure. I truly am not sure if he actually got hit. But like I said, he missed the first one. He makes the second one. Here's a third free throw.
And it's good. 26-13. 13-point lead. And the Panthers not out of this one yet, folks.
We just
need to get some stops, as AD says, and hit some shots. Lane with it now. He got a big three-pointer last time down, and he loses the ball. But they're going to reach and give him a foul. He got him on the hands. Johnny Johnson knows that that's a good one. Johnny Jones. I keep saying Johnson. Pardon me. Johnny Jones in his sixth year at Texas Southern University.
Good coach.
Very good coach. We've got three championships. Gazelius will come in and –
So, Nick, once again, he's
in for
three
opportunity. Yeah.
If he touches, he's got to put it up or he's going to be right back on the bench.
Hopkins will get a well-deserved breather. Miles will get it in now to Lane. He almost traveled and gets it back to McGaskey. McGaskey looking down low. Miles wants it, calls for it. McGaskey finds a hole in the lane, gets it back out to Charles Lane. Pow!
There you go. There you go. Now he's filling it.
16-26. The lead is 10. Smith pushing McGaskey into the defense. Now Lane is fired up. Lane working. Pulling back the defense on Grayson Carter. Oh, my goodness. And CeCe is a hooper.
Yeah, I mean, he's got,
Horton's coming right back.
He's got 10 points already.
Wide open. Lane thought about it. Stops. Puts it up from 15.
Good shot.
Now the Panthers are starting to hit their shot. The lathering rhythm.
You got to get a little rhythm.
8:30 left to play, 18-28 the score. Darius Watson, what's going on? I want to send a shout out to Slater Hayes. Oh, man, a whole bunch of people have joined him. Terrence Artis, former basketball point guard here at Prairie View University, my classmate watching us.
Nice.
And, well, they're listening here. They got to watch us on that. Here we go now to McCaskey. McCaskey looking, trying to set up the offense. 30-18 the score, right side lane. Thought about the three-pointer. Comes back right side. Miles wide open. Right inside the three-point lane. Misses it terribly, and we're going back the other way. Here comes CeCe. I think that's it. CeCe, we got to make sure.
I don't like when we take long twos. Like, you might as well just take the three.
You might step 1 foot back. You step right inside. Henry for three. Now, we know about P.J. Henry. He can play. Panthers have got to get in front of him. McCaskey gives it not to Lane. Thought about the three-pointer. Wants to work.
He's going to take
there
one on one.
Hunter. Here he goes. Gets him on the elbow. Got him in the air. Puts it up from five. Yeah.
I can tell once he touched that ball, he wasn't passing. He was going to throw up. But look, man, I'm going to let my guy Danny get on here.
AD, thank you so much for.
Hey, and let Danny know he owes me dinner for sitting in with him.
He owes you dinner?
He owes me dinner.
I know that's
absolutely
right. Thanks a lot, and athletic director, Mr. Anton Goff. No stranger to the mic. Does such a great job with us, man. I'm so fortunate to have an engaged athletic director. You good? An engaged athletic director in what's going on. And there's a break here, ladies and gentlemen. 33-20 to score. The Panthers down by 13. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter now coming to you with assistant women's basketball coach Danny Evans. Coach, the Lady Panthers did a great job, but before we get into what happened with the Lady Panthers, we were talking about softball season coming up. The 2024 season, the first team all-conference, Viviana Figueroa, Kaylin Massey, and sophomore go-get-it Garcia and Mia Nunez on the first team. On the second team, Aaron Talley, Destiny Smith, and Jericho Rojas, who won the conference last year, for God's sake. How does she make second team? Who voted for them? A bunch of haters. I'm sorry. Here we go back. And, oh, man, a great long snap there by Hunter.
Wow.
Coach, congratulations on your win. We're one step closer to that 6-3 that we talked about. Payne
got it.
With a great –
Was she amazing?
She's always amazing, but we're gonna corral them and talk about them in a little bit.
All right, no problem.
Here we go, left side now. Lane or Smith rather, throwing it back out. McGaskey puts it up for three. No.
Wow. Not, man.
Oh, pardon me. Yeah, that was McGaskey for three. No. Yeah, the Panthers are having some real problems shooting. Yeah. They are not in rhythm.
Right. And it looks like the defense is not rotating.
That was exactly what I was going
to
say.
But, you know, hey, it's always time to change. You gotta guard these guys, man.
Look at this play. Now watch Hopkins here. Look, right here. One, two, three. Look how high he's up there.
Man. I've watched him in practice. He's over the goal. I mean, he can dunk the ball and all of that, so. For a little guy, he just really gives up his body and very good, strong going to the bucket.
We got to hit those free throws.
Got to hit your free throws. I mean, hey, that's part of the game.
What do you think about Nunley's defense? I mean, he is just simply outstanding with his D.
Yeah. He's a ball hog, what you call it. We used to call him a ball hog, and he hawked that ball all day. And, you know, he sits down very well in a stance. And he doesn't get out of it. He doesn't go for any, like, just, you know, head fakes or any of that stuff. He stays low. And obviously he's a small young man already from stature, but his defensive stance is
– Well, he plays 6'9", yeah.
Right. He's in that ball dribble zone. He stays in it constantly. Okay, got to get some help side defense here.
CC. Kicks it in the corner, the Panthers almost get it and go back the other way. Yeah, we'll keep it. 5:55 left to play here in the first half, folks. 21-35 the score. Lane will come back in. The Panthers got a lot of work to do, but not insurmountable.
Right, and I think that's what they're trying to do, like a defensive, offensive, substitution here.
McCaskey from 20 gives it up the lane, gets it back. Now looks for Hopkins, getting it, come around the left side. Miles on the baseline, turns around, spins, puts it up off the glass. No, Lane. Can't get it.
Couldn't get his hands on it. He had his hands on it, but he couldn't hold on to it.
Nunley will come back in for defense now.
Right.
Kalen Farouk.
Farouk
has checked in. I'm trying to figure out if that is my classmate's son, Shawana Farouk, and her brother. They went to high school with me. I mean, how many Farouks do you know? You know?
Not too
long
many.
Shot by Farouk. Good. No good. And look. She's a hairdresser, and she does those braids, and his are kind of immaculate. Throw it away. Here come the Panthers.
Okay,
PJ Henry throws it away.
Good play.
Now here comes Hopkins. Hopkins going up for the funky donkey. Like, I don't care. And that would have changed things around, and Byron didn't like that.
Yeah. Because, I mean,
he had two people.
They need a play. They need
all right,
a
now here we go. Nunley gets it out to Hopkins. Hopkins wants to shock the world. He climbs up. Oh, woo, man. If he'd have hit that, though, the crowd would have lost
their minds.
And look.
He's not really ticked out
about it because the unmitigated gall, the audacity of a dunk. Stick around. We'll be back with more Inside East Panther Basketball.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
We're back live here in the William Nix Center. Charles Porter, Dr. Danny Evans. This Monday, 5:30 to 7 p.m. 5:30 and 7 p.m. the tip-offs for the men and women's game. We take on the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff, that makeup game. Danny Evans is excited about it. Oh, I'm excited about it. I think everybody's excited about it.
I hope so, because it's going to be a very important game for us because of the fact that they're above us in the standings. Anytime you get a team that's above you, you want to try and make sure that you take care of that one.
Oh, yeah, we got some other ramifications coming on. It's Don. She used to coach here. You used to coach there. Tell the truth and shame the devil Dr. Danny Evans. It's going to be some robber. It's going to be some profane language, some hard fouls. No, I'm just teasing.
See, I try not to add that to the program.
I'm going
to
tell the truth.
You're telling the truth.
Tell the truth and shame the devil.
I got you. Oh, great.
Farouk over there, the CC, and the five-second violation.
All right.
And look, Byron is right there telling 4:32. That's right. five seconds. Now the Panthers need to keep their head in the game. 23-35, man.
Well,
13 points.
Don't try and get it all back at one time.
But 12 points. Is it 12 points? Yeah, 12 point lead.
Don't try and get it back at all at one time.
Here comes Miles.
Gotta have that
step
layup,
and turn around. You got to hit this foul, and he'll go to the line for free throws.
Yeah.
That one going against Deion Stroud, the senior from Fresno, California, folks.
Right. So when you find yourself in this situation, you don't want to try and get it all back at once. They want to try and just, you know, get it down by at least 6 or 8 before the half. You know, that
would
be
something. Well, we got 40. That's 3 stops, Coach.
Right.
That's 3 stops. That's all we need is 3 stops. And we got to hit our free throws.
Man,
Coach, that's going to really, really plague us.
That won't help you if you miss some free throws. You got to make the free throws. So, but you just want to creep back into the lead. Like I said, they haven't played their best basketball yet. And so you just want to kind of just stick with things and then hopefully – you know, it will come around. That defense has to come around. But Nunley, man, he's changed the energy. That's for sure.
Oh, absolutely. He's gonna take it away.
Yeah, he's a ball hawk.
I want to send a shout-out to Tyron Barker, our web designer for Splendid Media. He's supposed to be at the game. He's got a pass at the gate. CeCe picks it back up, and now here we go back right side over to Carter. Carter looking left. CeCe steps back, throws it all the way in the corner on the left side to Stroud. Stroud throws it away, and here come the Panthers. Hopkins. Hopkins puts it up off the glass with the left hand, and a foul. A foul called on the Tigers. See, now, this is the old Byron that, you know, he was really, really frustrated after all of the injuries at the beginning of the season, and we just really couldn't gel.
Right.
There's a whole bunch of stuff going on, and Byron, man, was not a happy camper for a minute. But now this is the old I'm going to beat you with X's and O's Byron Smith. Man. We know, okay? Folks, 4:09 left to play, and this was Media Time. I'm Charles Porter, Dan, and Evans. We'll be right back with more exciting Panther basketball.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
We're back live courtside in the William Nix Center, a capacity crowd here in the Baby Dome. I don't see a – now, do the Panther Dolls need all those seats? I'm going to say it out loud.
I think they could have given up about.
Well, there are people standing up. They should have gave up about four rows.
Right, right.
Now, as an alum, shout us away, it's good.
Yep.
Okay, as an alum.
Correct.
As a life member with this gold card in my pocket.
Right.
Hall of Famer.
Okay.
About $20,000 in my life into the school program.
Okay.
I think I can say that they need to cut down on the seats. What you think?
Well, I mean, when you have it, obviously, when it's obvious like that, like they, you know, you have people standing instead of being able to sit in that a little more of that portion of that section, then yeah, I could agree with that.
Yeah, Coach Pete's gonna get me though. Oh well.
All right, let's go now.
Here we go, right side now. Coming down with it, the Panthers, man, with 26-12 in the paint points. They're just getting dominated in the paint. Here we go, left side. Farouk with a great pass down low, but McCaskey steals it away. Here come the Panthers off the bad pass. McCaskey, oh, great pass to Miles for two. That's how we got to start notching away at it, ladies and gentlemen. Notching away at it.
Creep back into the lead.
Sending a shout out to Crystal Edwards at Media Blitz. She's watching. Mia's doing a fine job. So happy to have her. Here we go back up top now.
Well,
Henry.
Conley has changed the intensity of the defense. Man, golly, he's picked it up.
CeCe coming around the right side, working on McCaskey. McCaskey with some good defense, turns and stays in his face. Got him on the arm and one. Yeah. Got him on the arm. No, you touched him on the arm. I know you put your hands up, but you got him. That's okay. Look how he looked at my arms. You know, we've been around these guys a long time, and I've been around Joe Wilbert, I know, for 25. How long has Joe been in the league? Long as you and I have been in the league?
You know what? These guys, I haven't really seen them because I've been in women's basketball all the time. So
oh, that's right.
Some of these officials, I don't really know them. I've seen him, though, around.
Yeah, Joe's been here forever. I asked him, I said, when you going to retire? He said, when you retire? I said, well, I ain't going to retire. He said, well, me neither.
Wow.
Hopkins with a double pump. Oh, and he's just beat up. Over there.
Dang, that was a foul. That's for sure.
Wow.
That was a foul. Golly.
That was real. If you go foul him, go foul him. That was one of those. If you go foul him, foul him. Yeah.
That's for sure. That was a foul. You didn't have to call. You didn't have to look at no monitor for that one. Golly.
Hopkins to the line. A 10-point lead now. Down to 10. 28-38. He can bring it down to 8. 3:13 left to play. We get it down to 4-6.
Right.
If not tied up, we got enough time.
Got
three pointers. That's all we need. Got
to make your free throws. Three.
Yes, that's okay. One of them. Right. That's two. You get three pointers. We're tied.
Right.
Well, but like, you got to get some stops.
Yeah, exactly.
You got to get some stops.
Defense has to pick up, and like I said, Nunley, he has done that. He's yeah. Picked the defense up, and now. You know what, he's kind of like, you know, it's spreading on the
other
guys.
They
get better.
Now, where are you originally from, Coach?
Flint, Michigan.
Flint, that's right. I should have known that. You know the Burks family then, Greg Burks and all of, yeah, well, they know you.
Oh, okay.
I was going to say, you got to get like a fly in the buttermilk in the defense here.
Okay.
Some real pesky defense there.
All right,
yeah,
that's
yeah. Fly in the buttermilk, shoot, fly, shoot.
Shoot,
that's, I guess that's more Southern. Oh,
that's an off.
Oh, man, way to regain composure there for Nunley. Man, Nunley's on him like a scuba diving suit. Oh, McCaskey gets it. On the fast break, McCaskey to Hopkins. Off the glass, Nunley gets it. Oh, my goodness. Now, that's the one he should have slammed. P.J. Henry with an easy one. That's the one he should have tried to slam. And the Tiger faithfully excited about it. Back to a 10-point lead, 2:30. Left to play.
They needed that basket right there, though, because a great defensive stop, and then you got to get a basket out of that.
Lane on the baseline throws it up.
Yep, good
and
foul.
A three, yeah, 3-point shot.
You drew that
three?
Foul. Nope. That's yeah, a 2-pointer. It's a 2-pointer.
Push. Ah, 2-pointer.
Yep, 2-pointer. But great way to get him up, though. He got him up and, you know, had him at his mercy then. He just couldn't finish the basket out, but he had him up in the air, and he had a chance to go ahead and try and see if he could make a three-point play, but he just couldn't get – he was fouled. Man, that was a – man. Yep.
Coming in at halftime, I'm looking across the way at head coach Bubba McDowell.
Oh, yeah.
So he'll be coming over right at the beginning. He'll take your spot right at the beginning of halftime for a few minutes. Then we're going to kick him off and get you back.
What if I don't want to move? I mean,
if you don't want, well, he'll just have to. Y'all, man, will y'all wrestle for it? I'd like to see that. Y'all fight for it?
I mean, hey, I want to talk about our game.
Well, we're going to talk about our game.
You told me I was going to be able to talk.
Oh, no. We're not going to. Come down. I know Sandy Pugh. What's wrong with you? You've got several families that were watching the game. The Hutchinson family watches every week.
Okay.
I'm gonna tell you who watches this.
All right.
The Hutchinson family, the Bowen
family. We
made
those two free throws, by the way, as well. Now we're trying to.
And the Waddle and Soders family don't miss a game, but the Soders family is here. Just found out that the Soders family and I have a different connection. I'm gonna tell you about it in a minute.
Okay.
2:11 left to play. My mother's watching. She's gonna trip.
Oh, okay. We need right a defensive side. Stop right now. It's 2:05 left. Come on.
Kicks it down right side, pushing it back to Young. Yeah, that's the foul we needed. Coming across and running over was Chris Craig running over Nunley. Or was that McCaskey? Yeah, it was McCaskey. That one kind of hurt. You can tell. Yeah, that one kind of hurt. 32-40, an 8-point lead. You said get it around an 8-point lead. I said 6 or 4. You said it, Coach. I said 6 or 4. We're at 8 now.
I think I've been at coaching a little bit longer than you've been at broadcasting, so I would suggest that I do know what I'm talking about.
39 years? How long you been coaching? You ain't been coaching 40 years,
well,
Coach. You ain't that old.
I wasn't coaching that much, but I played.
Okay, well, I played too, so.
another
blown opportunity there. We can't win this game like that.
No, you got to capitalize on the opportunities that are given, and we seem to. I don't know. It's just a night we don't have that ability to go ahead and capitalize on it and get us a bucket out of it. Oh, push off on
CC. Yeah, I'm gonna go back the other way. Here comes Lane for offense.
Got it.
Jessica Soder's grandmother, her mother's mother, and her mother grew up in my neighborhood. I didn't even recognize her.
Oh my goodness.
Miss McElroy was a third grade teacher at Grissom Elementary where I went to school. Her and my mother started teaching together. When my mama hears this, she is going to trip. Here we go back to live action. Right. Hopkins comes around on the curl, gives it over to Lane. Lane with a double pump. Aww. Oh, we got to hit those. Golly.
Don't foul him.
You got to hit those shots. Down a minute 24.
Okay,
8 points.
Sit down on defense.
Down low. Oh, and a foul called on Lane. You pushed him in the back, sir.
No, that wasn't Lane. That was Smith.
Smith. Pushing him in the back.
We needed a basket down there on that last opportunity.
Look, three opportunities. We've missed three baskets down there since the 8-minute mark.
Man, I just hate that for them. You got to realize when to slow it down and actually make sure you get a basket and when can you speed up. And I think we've been on a misnomer here. We're going on the wrong time.
Oh, easy for you to say after winning your game. No, I'm just teasing. That's a good one there. Come on, Coach. But you're absolutely right. No, I'm just trying to make it fun,
Coach.
Game.
I mean, we weren't perfect. That's what that is.
I'm trying to make it fun.
Okay.
Well, to send a shout out to Crystal Edwards over at Media Blitz and Erica Edwards and Christina Edwards, the staff at Media Blitz. We let Mia have the rest of the night off. Here we come back to right side. Lane puts it in from 20. We need that one.
Come on now, defense.
7 points.
Defense.
7 points. You said 8.
Oh,
nice one. Here we go. That should be easy. Come on, get that dunk. Oh, yeah. That's going to change the momentum in here, baby.
Yeah.
Yeah. The funky dunky.
No, come on now.
Under a minute left to play. The Panthers were down by 13. Now down by 5. Right side, PJ Henry.
Grab it.
Gets it to the Panthers. Here comes McCaskey. Out to Hopkins. Hopkins puts it up. Oh! And Hopkins, CC.
Yes.
With the foul, but I'm going to be real about it. Let's look at the replay. All right, here we come. Here comes.
Running to look at the replay.
Oh,
yes,
yeah, that's
foul.
A foul.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, that's a. Well, he was fouled by the first. I didn't see who that first player was. Fouled
the
him.
The first guy.
Okay,
didn't
the first
really
foul got him. Yeah,
but the second guy.
He got him enough for a call, though. Here comes the pass down to Hopkins. Now, he's fouled right there. Now, that's the
that's
other
the
one.
Foul, yeah.
That's the hurt foul.
Well, it was a foul regardless.
When
did it happen? I don't care. Now you got to make his free throws, though. That's what we got to do.
Want to send a shout out to Leonard Gant. And General, is my classmate a general now? I think so. Yeah, my classmate, his wife, Antoinette Gant. She's probably going to be the commander of the 7th Fleet, but Antoinette Gant, I think she's a general now. Shame on me. Shame on me for not knowing that. I know it, but I just forgot.
You might want to write some stuff down.
I know that. I don't have to write that down. Well, I saw him watching. So I want to send a shot, but I'm pretty sure she's a general.
Oh, wow.
Antoinette Gant, my classmate, went to Prairie View. We all got here together, Antoinette Gant and myself. We all came at the same time.
Come on, man. Yeah, there you go. We got one of the two on the free throws.
37.
Come on now.
To 41.
We need a defensive stop here. We need the ball.
Well, it's down to my lead. You said
right,
eight.
Exactly.
I said four.
I was just hoping for eight because the way we were playing.
Absolutely.
We
were down 13. You're absolutely
but now,
right.
You know what? They're playing so much. They've capitalized on a couple of those turnovers that we had now. So we got a foul. He missed the one free throw, but he made the other one. So that was good. Now we got to sit down and stop him right here. Shot clock down.
Here we go.
Nope. No way.
No way. And the Panthers, right. The shot clock with the Panthers will have 7 seconds to do it. We're talking about the turnovers.
Good shot here.
Texas Southern with 13 turnovers. The Panthers with 6. So we're taking care of the ball.
Yep.
Texas Southern is giving us an opportunity. I'm interested to see the points off turnovers. Let's see. Poor points off turnovers. They don't have that. Stat. It'll be on the other stat sheet.
We need a basket right now. That's what we need. If we can get a basket going out of his,
Don't worry about it.
What a
7 seconds. Oh yeah, man. Yeah, especially something like a big three-pointer or a dunk or maybe a three-pointer and an and-one to tie it up.
I'll take two. Anything.
All right, here come the Panthers, folks. Down to 7 seconds. Here come McGaskey in the corner. Lane thought about the three-pointer. Now steps inside from 20. Hits the side of the iron, no good. And, wow, man, great play. Good play. Had it where we wanted it. It just didn't fall.
I think he should have hit the three.
Yeah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's halftime here in the William Nix Center. The Panthers are down by 4. 41-37 after being down by as many as 14. They have come roaring back to take on the Tigers here for the second half. Stick around. This is exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View and M Panther Sports Network.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Hey, Don. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Yeah. I just messed up the whole program, beat it off the board, knocked it down, didn't ask you ever can. And now I live right. All night, all right. Just turn me off the bus and beat it like a mic. Tell her don't run from this pipe. Let me see where it look. Go ahead, shake some. Your chick going no, she just put my chains on. Got her going crazy, let it shake and watch her move. Told her you gotta run it up. You're not the one who make the rules. Left, right, let me see you do it. Left, do it, right, do it.
Cell phone at the scorer's table. A lost cell phone. You'll need to identify it. When you come down here, we're not just going to give it up. You need to identify it. Thank you.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Prairie View. And here are the halftime stats up. The Tigers are shooting 63% from the field. The Panthers only a dismal 39%. 20% from the charity stripe, or the three-point range, pardon me, is the Texas Southern Tigers. Prairie View, only 25%, just a little bit better from the three-point range. But Texas Southern amassing 15 rebounds to 10. And that's the difference, the rebounding and also the points off of turnovers. The Tigers with 6 points off turnovers, but of the 9 turnovers that they have, the 13 tech turnovers, we scored 12 points off of their turnovers. That's been the difference.
Right. Well, obviously, if you look at their shooting percentage, I mean, they're shooting 63%. If they can continue that for a whole basketball game, that's almost incredible. They're shooting 63% as a team. I mean, so we're going to have to, the defense going to have to pick up keep them from shooting that well. I mean, they're shooting 63%. You gotta cut that down with some defense. I mean, that's unbelievable to be shooting 63%. And then we obviously got to pick ours up, make some of these layups we've missed, and more free throws. I don't know what is the free throw percentage for us?
The Panthers from the charity stripe for the first half are shooting 81.3%, 13 of 16.
Wow,
from the free throw line.
Like we missed more than that many free throws, but yeah, if we're 16-13, that's pretty good. 13-16 is okay.
So you go in, you go in down 4 after being down by as many as 13.
Right.
Your team battles back. You settle them down at halftime. What do you tell your team coming out here in the second half?
Okay, so they have the momentum right now. We have the momentum. You want to hone in on that and let the team know that, hey, obviously we got to keep that momentum going when we step back out here. You don't want to come back in here and say, okay, we've arrived. they have not arrived yet. They're going to have to pick that defensive up, and that 63% is going to have to change for Texas Southern. And our defense is going to have to dictate that. They're not going to stop shooting 63% if you're not defending them. So that's what we gotta have happen. We're going to have to defend them and go from there.
Well, I'm thinking the same thing. I was trying to get Tay's attention. That's okay. 2:10 left until we get this one underway. I want to remind you, ladies and gentlemen, our video production has been provided by Woodlawn Entertainment, James Crenshaw and his entire crew. I just started being a part of his crew. He doesn't know that I'm on his team yet, but I'm on his team. TV production, sports production, any type of video, audio production you need, weddings, commercial videos, videography, editing, voiceovers, whatever you need, we can get it to you. That's Woodlawn Entertainment, located somewhere in a quiet place in Mississippi. Not going to tell you where, but located somewhere in Mississippi. Somewhere in the Delta where the catfish is just tasty.
In the Sip.
The Sip.
I heard
been
that.
There many, many, many times. I tell you, this swag life is great. And I've got some T-shirts that are about to come out. That's what say swag life. I got a great design. My intern over here, my new person, Mia Greer over there, is working on the design, and she's very, very good at it. Oh, man, I'm just so excited about these young people working with us. I tell you, we've always had a great group of people, but it just seemed like they get better and better. Justice is 30 years old. She's been working with us forever. Now, Justice is about 23.
Okay.
She has been a still. How old are you, Justice? 26. She old as dirt. I'm almost.
I told you need to write some things down.
But she keeps coming back.
That's my point right there. You got to write this stuff down.
She knows she ain't no 33 years old. She just graduated last year.
Well, she got a pretty smile, so that's good.
Oh, I mean, and she does a great job with our stats. Madison, I can't remember Madison's name. The video board is not easy.
I can imagine.
And Madison is over there. Doing a great job with our graphics and video relays, folks. Don't forget, coming up on the 24th and 25th of March is the Prairie View Relays. I told him the wrong date.
Okay.
Traditionally, it's been April 6th, or is that the PV? Is that the Texas Relays that's April 6th?
Okay.
Something is April 6th.
I have no idea.
What's the first Sunday in Easter? I'm out, darn. I mean, in April, I told you already.
April Fools?
I don't know. First Sunday in April.
April Fool's Day.
You got me stuttering talking about Jesus' Day like that. You better.
Oh, my bad.
That's Easter, the resurrection.
Easter, yes.
The third day, the sepulcher, rolled away.
Came back.
He's not there.
Came back. and came as a vision to him. Like,
John, wow. James, Peter. I just saw the master's guy. He was walking with us on the road. Okay, I'm going to leave it alone.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. 41-37, the Panthers have really got to keep their head on the swivel, keep their head going.
We gotta come in here and change that defensive effort to get that 63% down to about 40%. They can't shoot that well. Can't allow them to shoot that well, so therefore defense has to change.
McCaskey at the top of the key slips it down on the left side. Oh, great pass inside from Charles Smith. They give it back over to Brian Miles with a double pump. He puts it off, and it's off the mark. And now, man, we got to capitalize on that. They lose the ball. Nunley, the bothersome Nunley, gets it over on the right side. And
he is a problem.
Right side with it down low.
No one let that happen. Step out. Okay.
Here we go, up top, left side.
All right,
with
we got him down 5 seconds.
Stroud
come on, defense.
Comes with the dribble drive, puts it up from 20, hits the back of the air, no good.
Come on,
good
Miles. Defense.
Oh, Miles can't hold on to it. And the Tigers come up with a jump ball. It's going to stay down on their side.
Dang. We needed that ball right there. We needed that one. That
every was a, possession
is it matters.
Is vital. There you go. I was trying to figure out where every
it
possession
matter.
Matters. We got to do something.
And that was one where we had great defense. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. They shoot the ball and we don't get the rebound. That's not going to be good.
41-37. The score, Byron at half court. Quick throw in, CeCe.
Don't let him come off of that. Get up.
Ah. Shot is away.
All right. Got the ball.
It's good. No good. Okay. And we're going back the other way. McCaskey. Right.
Well, that was a good defensive stop. We finally got the ball back now. Now we got to do something offensively to make a basket here.
Hopkins.
Cut this thing down. Oh, that's
Smith
a bucket.
For three.
Yes.
Boom. Look good. Right Smith. Off the curl. Now the Panthers are down by one.
All right,
ladies and gentlemen, 41-40. The Panthers down by one.
Let's get down. Get down on defense. Come on now.
Here comes P.J. Henry on the left side. Now takes it right. Oh, man. And Henry popped Nunley in the face, pushed him off in the face.
I think that's starting to bother him in his dribble zone all night long.
Oh, yeah, he's frustrating him. He can't do anything.
You can ask him what he had for lunch, and he knows.
So Nunley would have looked. He said he found Nunley in an alley. Yeah. I said, man, where'd you find this cat? He said, well, I found him in an alley. I fed him a couple of times, and he kept coming back. So we just put him on the team.
That's what I told you. He didn't know. If they asked him what he had for lunch, he would know, because I'm telling you.
Meow,
oh,
mix.
That's a bucket.
Smith, boom, turns around, and the Panthers take their first lead of the game, ladies and gentlemen. 42-41, the score, the Panthers in the lead. Oh, 43, pardon me, 41.
Keep moving on defense. No. Get him back in there. There you go.
CC.
About to say.
Outside. Now brings it left side. He tripped.
Walk. A walk.
And they're gonna. He kind of got it. Tripped him.
Wow. I thought that was a travel.
But that's
too.
On the floor. Okay, here's the replay. CC working on Hopkins. That takes him right. Now pushes off on him and takes him left. Trying to create some space so he can get around him. And he just tripped. The reach was the foul when he reached in, but he didn't touch it.
Ah, man, we got a foul here.
That's on the floor, no bucket. Smith is going to be called for this one. Ah, golly gee. Okay, now come on, guys. Keep our heads in the game here. 43-41.
He's a shooter. And so, therefore, we got to. Okay, come on. They're not shooting free throws. That's good. All right, come on. Get strong.
Yeah, that one was on the floor. He committed it on the floor.
Switch, Miles Smith. There you go. There you go. Hand up. Oh, don't hold him. Don't foul.
Cece in the corner. Gets it back for three.
Oh, no
puts
hand
it up
at
wide
that.
Open. Come on. No good. Stroud gets the rebound. Back out to P.J. Henry. He'll hit it. No. And some good basketball. Oh, where's the punch? They're letting him play. And Miles throws him down on the ground.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow.
Come on, Miles. Wow.
Well, he popped Miles in the face. Watch. Goes back up. Puts it down. Oh, wow.
They're going to have to go to the tape on that.
They're going to look at that.
They're going to have to go to the video.
He was on his shoulder.
I don't think
he pushed him down. I think he snatched. Look, Byron. They're gonna put him in, and man, boy, I'd hate to be him.
What did it? I'd like to see that replay of that. Here we go.
Okay, here it is. He bowed him there. See, he already bowed him. He's got his hands around
his
neck.
Yeah.
And he's over his back with his hand around his neck.
Maybe they.
It's Cisse.
They're coming to look at it now.
Yeah, Cisse is gonna be it. Okay, let's see. There it is right there. He bowled him.
He
bowled him in the stomach.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to walk this one down. What do you do? You give a double technical?
He got him right here in the stomach.
Yeah, he bowled him in the stomach right here when he came down. He got him twice. And he came over with his hand on his back. He's pulling him.
Yeah.
He's pulling him down.
Right. I mean, and he's shoving him off of him.
He's pulling him down. I wouldn't call that a flagrant. I would call it. I call it a double technical.
I wonder what they're going
to tell him and give him a 2-minute timeout apiece. You sit down for 2 minutes. And you sit out for 2 minutes, but man.
Yeah, he's shoving him off of
him. He shoved him off of him, and he bowled him in the stomach.
Yeah.
No call there, Leonard Gant.
Did they see the bow in the stomach, I wonder?
I hope so. I want to send a shout out to Delphia Esters. who's watching us. Man, we are so blessed and fortunate. Paul Stroller is watching us. Sid Brass is calling us. A lot of new people, man. Latrice, oh, hey, baby. My classmate, Lord. Baby listening
you
to us.
You having a homecoming on.
We just lost a classmate on Monday, and the Marlin family have really been following. I don't know any details. I'm not going to put nothing out because y'all know the situation.
Right.
We're not saying nothing. We're going to let Michael and his family handle that, and we're going to put our homegirl down right. Monique Mingo passed on Monday.
I'm sorry to hear that.
One of the prettiest girls at school. You know, really? You ever see one of the prettiest girls at school?
Right, right.
And you know, everybody thought she was a big meanie because she was one of those pretty girls that's always mean. At least she had the look.
Right.
But she loved some Charles Porter, and I loved her too. She was a very close classmate. We was in Ms. Williams' history class together. Me, her, and Jessica Rogers. The two prettiest girls at school.
Right,
I was in class with them, and we did our work together. And she's going to be sorely missed. My heart goes out to the Mingo family as well. It's Terrence Finna. We call him T-Boy. I was her boyfriend, and it's just tough. Kirk Freddy, thinking about you too, my brother. We're really close. I remember eighth grade. I'm just going to leave it at that. All right, let's see what it's going to be. It's going to be a double technical. Personal foul against TSU.
So did they throw Miles out the game, or he just took him out?
A technical foul.
Just took him out. Come out of there, ball.
Wait a minute. How did they get? They called a technical foul. He said a personal foul. But why is he shooting technical foul shots? That doesn't make sense. He said it was a personal foul, but he's shooting technical foul. What? Hold on. Let's get what happened.
Oh, man.
All right, there you
go.
You got a
Come
personal foul and then a dead ball technical foul. Well, they didn't put him out, though. He's still in. He's not disqualified because he's sitting on the bench, so that's
okay.
Fine.
Right.
So they give him two fouls? They give him the tech and the regular foul and the personal. So he picks up two fouls. They give him the technical foul
and a personal
and the personal foul. That's
wow.
Just makes me want to
So how many does Miles have now?
Well, wow. I'm trying to check here. Miles number three for the Panthers, 3-3, has two. That was his first two fouls. Well, that's okay.
Okay, then that works for
us. That works for us. Yeah. And keeps the momentum going. 46-43, the Tigers up by three here, folks, with 17 minutes left to play here in the first half.
Come on now. Give me a three ball.
Smith thought about it, steps inside, now goes back into the corner, puts it up for three, we're tied.
He on fire.
Yeah, baby. Smith is on fire. Man,
he's on fire.
Worth the price of the ticket, there is not an empty seat. PJ.
Don't foul him.
Come on, Horton. 16-42. Well, I stand corrected, Coach. It's 46-45.
Right. We're down one.
And Kirby, Henry, pardon me, will go to the charity stripe for free throws. Again, want to send a shout-out to Uncle Boo. We're going to be coming by getting some catfish later here. Uncle Boo's barbecue right there at 701 University Drive. It's Sandra Bland Parkway right now. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Uncle Boo's Catfish Corner, always a campus favorite. They say they're a campus favorite.
That's now, like when they have game day.
Yeah.
Game day, and they bring food to them, so I'm waiting on mine then.
Well, no, it's a food truck.
Oh, no. So I'm talking about right here. We should be eating on the thing.
No, we have to go afterwards. He told us to come afterwards. Coach Danny Evans,
I want to be on air, and I can actually give him – oh, man, hey, this is great.
You know what? I like that. 16-42.
Game day. That's what they do. They give them food.
Well, they're supposed to bring out here so we can see if we want to buy some for the teams, right?
Exactly.
Here comes Charles Smith around the right side. Smith, oh, man, with a running jump high off the glass.
He on fire tonight. He on fire. He came to play. He determined. And I don't know. I know something about being determined that he's going to play his heart out. He's playing his heart out. Don't foul him. Rock.
Cisse.
Don't foul.
Turns around. Oh, wow. Oh, Moses, get on out of here. Lane with the rebound, and we're coming back. That's the kind of stuff that we need.
Yes.
Charles, my boy, if he'd hit that three-pointer right here, I'd have ran out of here with everybody.
All right, now we need to get a basket here. They got to be able to set up something to get them a good shot.
McCaskey
to
Miles.
They're going to be all on Smith.
Smith for three. Looks good. Nope. In and out. Oh, man, that looks good from here.
Come on, stop ball. Stop. I'm sorry.
That's okay, Kirby. He's supposed to stop the ball. Hey, I'm into it. Cissé is 11. Cissé.
I'm coming with my basketball.
Hey, coach, keep on. Don't stop. Shots away. No.
Grab it.
Get the rebound. Grab it. That's just it. Stroud gets the rebound. They get it over to P.J. Henry in the corner. Henry looking deep three-pointer. Ooh. That's nasty. 51-47, man. The Texas Southern faithful are fired up in that little common area.
That was that one possession. See, that's what, man, he didn't grab that ball.
McCaskey coming around the right side, kicking it in the corner. Lane coming around the right side. Smith throws it up. No.
There we go. Yep.
Lane was coming off that curl there here on that wing play. Yep. He was wide open. That's why I said that. And, man, gee whiz, the Panthers.
But the one thing, though, they did settle down, and they ran an offense and got a good shot.
15-14 left to play here. 51-47. The Panthers are down by four. Stick around. We'll be back with more.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
To the William Nix Center. I think our engineer keeps forgetting that they have provided us with a monitor so we can kind of see. But I tell you, man, we are state of the art right here, folks, with Woodlawn Entertainment. We've got monitors. We've got crowd noise. We've got dancing girls. No, I'm just teasing. But we've got it all together. My main man got it together. I'm just so exceedingly happy. You know, we got off to a slow start, Coach. We ain't going to talk. But to be back to where we are now, Coach, is a 1,000,000%. If you go and watch our games on YouTube, you would think you're watching ESPN, because you are. You're basically. They have pulled some of our games to run. They have pulled the Alabama A&M game. The ESPN3 is going to run the A&M game during the summer when they don't have anything else running. They just run replays. Well, our Alabama A&M game is going to be one of those games. The women and the men.
Come out of there. That's all.
Stroud shoots it up. No good.
Yep.
It's an air ball. Here come the Panthers. 51-48.
There you go. All right.
Down three. McCaskey at the top now on Cissé.
That's good he didn't try something. Earlier they were just trying to get something up there.
Smith has to go for it, and it's going to go down to the Tiger side. Let's see what they're doing.
That's a foul.
Jump ball, and it stays down here at the Panthers side. Good call there by Wilbert. Joe Wilbert III, Winston Trotter, and Jean-Pierre out there.
We can't get fined for saying that's a bad call, can I?
As long I don't know, no, as long as you don't, you know, just berate. I don't think if you berate, if you think it's a bad call, it's your personal opinion. Okay, I mean, right. Hey, I think it's a bad call.
That was a foul.
If you get a fine, the Panther faithful gonna pay for it. Latrice Bebe Allen's gonna put some money in. Dalton Minton, Gregory Hazley, Bishop Livingston, my son Lorenzo Porter watching. Oh, man, it's just going great.
Well, I appreciate it, but that was a foul. I mean, I just don't see how you can't call something out of that.
Coach, I ain't got a bunch of money. I got a little jewelry. Ain't that what Birdman said? I ain't got no money. Corner. I got some jewelry.
I mean, they're obviously trying to stop him because he's been scoring and shooting so well.
Down 10 seconds on the shot clock. Smith has it knocked away, and it stays here. Now down to 7 seconds. Catch and shoot. We got a couple of minutes.
Well, he's awesome with that. He's a catch and shoot guy. So when he
That's why they got him over there. But they're going to pull him back now, and they're going to run a curl play. Watch. They're going to try to bring him from the other side, shooting in. Nope, they're not.
There he is.
There's Lane. A curl. Come they on. Do it to Lane, though. Lane's got to shoot it. There it is. Ooh, wee. Off the back of the iron, no good. But that's the curl play up top. They run it with Lane instead of Smith.
Okay.
Cisse, is that right? That's a curl play, right? Off the.
You got that one.
All right. Here comes Cisse. Oh, he steps back in, and he's very good with that because he looks as though he travels as he takes that step back.
Yeah, but you got.
So the defender gets off of him because I'm telling you, I've watched it every time. Every time he steps back, the defender lets up off the defense. Here comes McCaskey, finds a hole. Oh my goodness. Wow, don't pull him, Coach. That's not a time to pull a player like that because he gonna make that one up. He's playing some great defense.
He need to get it right now,
he's
then.
Playing good defense. McCaskey. Now they're going to pull him because he commits the foul. Wow.
It's an offensive play.
3-4.
We're going to stay here. And Cisse is going to go to the line for free throws. Golly gee, 55-48. The Panthers had the lead to 2. Or to 3.
Well, like
and,
I said.
And now.
I said that earlier. You got to.
The lead is 9 now.
Defensive end, you got to keep it up. You know, you can't let it down. And then they haven't been scoring. You know, they're putting some defense on Smith now. They're not allowing him to just get open looks anymore. I don't think that's going to happen.
Yeah, the Tigers on a 6-0 run. And Smith going after it with Granger. Real? And they're going to call Granger for the foul.
They're getting real physical with Smith down here because he's hit those jump shots and he's on fire. And they're trying to put it out.
Kobe Granger following in his father's footsteps as a guard and a starter here for Texas Southern. Got to be proud of that, man. Nunley gives it back on the right side. Horton stops, puts it up. We need a shot. Yeah, baby. There you go. Now, come on now. We need to get him involved. He hadn't been hitting anything tonight.
Nope.
Horton is coming off of a 20-point game against Alabama A&M.
His main thing is penetration, which is where he.
Man, yeah, I saw that when it left P.J. Henry. We know Henry can shoot the 3. 12:58 left to play. Nunley getting the 2.
He better put him on 3. That little dude can shoot it.
Well, no doubt about it. Left side with it. Hopkins has it up top to Nunley. Nunley wants to get it to Lane. Now Smith will have it on the curl. Comes around the defense. Finds a hole. Kicks it in the corner. Lane for 3. He's fouled. And he's going to shoot 3.
That's what he should have did earlier in that
absolutely.
That halftime. He should have shot that ball. That's what
when he was down here in the corner, on the right side? Yeah, absolutely.
Same thing would have happened. That guy came through his arm.
He was shooting the ball. That should be 3. Wait a minute. He was shooting the ball. What? Wasn't he shooting the ball? That's supposed to be he was shooting the ball.
Oh, my God.
What the heck was that?
Right there.
Nunley for 3.
Nope. That's not his game.
Miles tries to get the long rebound.
God. That's a foul.
And the rolling block.
That's his. How many personals on that?
Is that going to be on Miles? Is he going to give a foul to Miles? It's going to be his third.
Okay.
Lane will come out. McCaskey will come in and check back in. Now the guard rotation with McCaskey, Hopkins and Nunley.
I still don't see why they didn't call that foul. When
the three shots right here. What happened there?
Okay.
Maybe our minds playing tricks on us.
Nah.
We saw the same thing. Okay, that's what I figured.
He was shooting the ball. They called a foul, and all of a sudden it's a on the floor foul. The dude was shooting the ball.
Right side, Cisse. Ooh, took.
Nope.
Nunley, no prize though. Nunley gets it back, shoots it over there to Hopkins. Hopkins is foul, no call. He's foul, no call. Wow. Bad call. Gee whiz. 11:54 left to play. A 9-point edge by the Tigers. Well, I just don't know what to say about that one.
Well, it's all about communication on defense. If you're not communicating, then, hey, all kind of bad things can happen.
I tell you, the Texas Southern fans showed up. Here comes McCaskey. McCaskey with a dribble drive, looking down low, can't find Nunley. Now in the corner, Charles Smith, the fourth, turns, twist. Oh, man, he has it stripped away. Miles gets it back and puts it back in with a strong one. And that's going to be a media timeout here on the court, ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers. We're going to look at something. Well, wait a minute. Let's see before we go. It's the remix. Okay, they're going to call. Personal foul, personal foul. What's going on?
He calling
a tech? A double tech?
He wanted a foul on this.
Was he calling a double technical?
He wanted a foul on the play, and I think he went after the official here.
They're going to watch this one. Okay, here we go. When they're doing that, the people need to come off the court. When they're reviewing a play, you can't be on the court. That's the rule.
Okay.
The reviewing the play. The players are still on the court. You got to be mindful of what you're doing.
I mean, that's that right there, number four, right there.
Ooh. Ooh-wee. Well, we're standing here live, folks. Don't forget, coming up March 24th and the 25th is the Prairie View Relays. Now, here's we're watching it. And give her a nice round of applause. Let's try to help her. Here comes our friends from Luxury Goods, Brandon and Naima Townsend. And Brandon Jr. over there. And our friends from Luxury Goods doing it with a nice little prize there for the non-singer. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say that out loud? I didn't say she can't sing. Want to send a shout out to Maurice Jackson. Send your child to Prairie View. Maurice Jackson's done. Well, if you can't sing, you can't sing. I shouldn't have said it, but I did.
Right.
She can't sing. She don't need to participate in that game ever again.
You know,
not the singing game.
One thing it's called is practice.
You need to. Well, if that's the case, she needs to.
Sing.
Well, if practice is what she needs to start over. 11:16 left to play, man. The Panthers having it rough here. 61-52, ladies and gentlemen. We're talking about the points in the paint. 34 points. They call double technicals, but on who? Did they offset no five step? But who they call? Charles Smith and who?
Him and the other guy who was on the other team.
No kidding. Then you're going to call a tech against his own teammate?
Man, it's crazy.
He said the tech was between Charles Smith and the guy on the other team. Okay. Well, but I'll take that one.
Violent.
Yeah, don't stick your foot out there like that. Oh, man, wow. P.J. Henry again, streaking towards the free throw line. Back to an 11-point lead here, 63-52. McCaskey coming right side, shooting it down over. Now here comes McKinley Harris. Hadn't seen a lot of time. McCaskey back up, looking left, spins, goes in the corner. Here comes McKinley Harris. from Dallas, Texas. And Nunley in the land of the Giants had nowhere to go. No help over there. No help backside. Charles Smith is up off the bench.
Yeah, you want to keep him around.
The graduate student from Atlanta, Georgia. We need some shooting. McCaskey, oh, Nunley almost got that one. P.J. Henry tried to do a James Harding and couldn't get it. Here comes, and Nunley knocked to the ground. Three? I think they call that one on 40. Who are they calling that one? 11?
Somebody fouled it, that's for sure. I think it was four. Yeah, it was number four.
10 minutes left to play here. Media timeout here on the court. Ladies and gentlemen, whoa, the Panthers 60, or the Tigers 63, the Tigers 52. Stick around, we'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Coach, got a text said you're a little low here. Let me turn down my headphone. Are you good there? Give me a mic check, Coach.
1-2-1-2.
What? Probably when the action got a little loud, they couldn't hear you.
Hey, I might have got upset when that last foul was.
Give me a time you was using those words.
I might have knocked all the wires apart and everything. Yep.
10 minutes left to play in this one. 52-63 the score. Nunley will be at the charity stripe to shoot free throws. First shot is away. Ooh-wee. We are having a rough night here.
He got to stay up on his heels off that one. I ain't like the delivery on that one. Come on now.
Second shot is away.
Nope. Dropped his heels.
Man. No good, yeah.
Oh, man. Too flat.
Down to 10 minutes, 11-point lead, 63-52. And the foul is going to be called on McCaskey for reaching. Zero,
Well, we at the point, I think they're trying to grab the basketball instead of just staying solid defense. That's what's going to get them back in the game. Not a lot of, you know, trying to hurry this thing up. It's not something that you can hurry up. You got to wait and play solid defense and get the ball that way.
Panthers in the 1-1.
They're going to have to play some solid defense and just get it. Right now they're trying to slap at the ball and all that. That's going to.
Chris Craig at the line for his first free throw attempts of the night. First
come
shot
out of
is
there,
away.
Ball. Come out of there.
It's good.
Come on, guys. Give him the ball. Let's go. I mean, really. Come out of there, ball. Come on.
Second shot is away. It's also good. Gee whiz.
Yep. Well, that's
Jeffrey
what
Jernigan, what's going on? Jeffrey Jernigan, senior, former Prairie View University standout basketball player. Watching this live on Splendid Media. Here we go, right side, Hopkins takes it to the corner, back up top to Charles Smith. Smith over to McCaskey. McCaskey wanted, wanted Byron Miles. And he has that one. Cisse throws it right into the hands of P.J. Hendry.
He can shoot it. My man number three can shoot the ball. P.J. Henry.
Henry, oh, yeah.
You got to get your hand up on him. Let's see what we're going to do on defense now. They should have put other guy, Horton, up here on him. Why do they have Williams up here on him? Smith.
He has it knocked away. Oh, and gets it back. Man, how do you make a good play?
Oh, my God.
And just let it slip away. He stole the ball and gave it back, and then they steal it again. And I think Byron. Well, they wanted to get Horton in, so they didn't get that sub in.
But they had a bad matchup when they had Smith up here on the little P.J. Henry guy.
P.J. Henry, yeah, absolutely.
And see, he's going to penetrate on him, and then that's what happens. It breaks down your defense. They should have put Horton or one of the other guys up there, I would have thought. But I got, obviously, they couldn't get him back over there. They couldn't switch back. So. Definitely don't want to have a mismatch on defense.
Craig will take it out. And kick it back out to P.J. Henry. Henry's going
to. Now he's trying to switch him up there, Horton. That's what I'm saying, man. You got to get him up there on this guy. Get them little guys up there on that dude.
Horton gives it up now to Granger.
Switch.
Back to Cisse.
Oh.
Cisse coming around the right side. He had to hold him, and he's with that running jumper. He's dangerous.
Man.
And that was going to go.
Hopefully our way. Yes. Uh-oh.
Well, that's going to go against Texas Southern. That's
hey,
going to go against Kobe Granger.
You got to hit these free throws.
Man. Well, yeah, absolutely. We've got a lot of time left here. Coming to 15-point edges.
Miles at the line. He got to knock these. I mean, this could be a wake-up call right here to get us some. Ball's going through the basket. He missed the 1-1. Oh, man. Okay. We're about to get it on the defensive end now. Sit down.
Henry gives it up now to Granger. Granger coming right side.
He got too many on the other side. It's overload.
Stops. Nope. Back for three. Wow. Cisse, a junior from Lafayette, Louisiana. Right side in the corner.
Right back. Oh, yeah.
Smith in the corner. Hopkins now with the dribble drive. Gives it over to Miles. Miles is fouled with a reverse layup. And that one is going to go against Hunter. Kenny Hunter, the junior from Shreveport, Louisiana. Man, it's rough here in the Baby Dome, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around. We'll take a break and come back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M.
Wow.
Panther Sports Network.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just a touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
We're back live here in the William Nix Center. Darn it. Left the music up again. Sorry about that, guys. 70-52, the score. Man. Coach, wow. I don't know what to say here. The Panthers just getting dominated in the point, in the paint. That's where they're losing to that coach. 38-22 points.
Well, you're playing with basically one main post player, which is Miles.
Miles,
I mean, he can't rebound them all. You know, you got a lot of little guys around him. Smith is not a rebounder.
He's a shooter.
He's a shooter. And so you got
Harris is a shooter. I mean, he's got all shooters. There's really no other.
We need another post player that maybe can come in and help him out, you know, give him a little break or something. Because, I mean, he got to hit these free throws, though. This is the only way they're going to creep back in it, making some of these free throws they've been missing.
Well, the Pine Bluff men aren't a slouch. Let's just say that. They're no slouch.
Oh, no. They can play.
They can play. So we're going to have to rebound here. Not throwing in the towel early, but 54-70.
Oh, no. It's still opportunity. You know, it's still minutes left. That means you got an opportunity. They got to have defensive stops, though, right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, Cissé is killing them with 28 points.
Right now. Yep. See, that's
– well, 25.
Definitely not going to work right there.
McCaskey.
Give up a backdoor layup.
Comes up, brings it right, shoots it to Hopkins.
And where is Smith? And you got all your shooters out. Where is
– Hopkins steps back. He'll shoot it up, and he'll pop it for two. .653 left to play. Cissé with it, and they've just given it to him to run everything. Left side. That was Chris Craig. Craig kicks it over left, going to PJ Henry. Henry.
Don't let him shoot.
Comes around the right side, wide open.
Come on,
Hunter for two. No long rebound. Nobody's blocking out. Miles gets it over to McCaskey. McCaskey stops, pops, and rolls in easy for him. 56-72. We've got to get it here quickly. Back down to 12 at the 5-minute mark. That's what I'm looking at.
Yeah, they got to hurry up for that.
Henry.
So now.
Working.
Push
he pushed off,
off
on him. Yeah, he pushed off.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Nunley on him like a glove. Can't do anything but push off on him. Harris. Lane will check in, and Charles Smith will come back in.
So I was going to say, got to get a shooter, some scorers in there. Man, you need another big guy, another post on defense.
McCaskey at the top of the key. Going around the Miles pick, back into the hands of Charles Smith. Smith comes left, looks in the corner. Nunley thought about it, now puts it back over out to Lane for good. Yeah, for three. That's what we need.
Get up on him. Got a new ball handler in the game. He wants to get up on that guy.
Yeah, 61-72.
Get up on him.
Got him down to an 11-point lead. Now, here we go. There it is. And,
oh
my goodness, almost a good one right there. 10 seconds, brother.
Come on,
Cissé
get up.
Wants it.
Don't let him shoot it.
Don't let it get up on him. Cissé coming down the right side. Sends Nunley over to the right side but misses the shot.
Come on.
No
come
prize
on.
At the end.
Come
here
on,
comes
Lane.
McCaskey. McCaskey looking
come
right
on,
left side.
More. Get it back to
looking
him.
Up top
on,
now.
Lane.
Here comes McCaskey. Stop right coaching, here. Coach. Left side. Here we go. Over the Miles. For two. There we go. 63-72. And the Panthers going on a mini run here.
Here we go.
And we need some defense here. 63-72 down to 4 minutes and 39 seconds left.
Right there.
Oh, there he is.
Ooh.
And who kicked it?
Man.
Weisinger kicked it, or did he say Nunley kicked it?
Nunley kicked it.
That's
good. See, they got a new ball handler in. They put the what's the name?
Cissé.
Henry.
Weisinger's the ball handler, and then they got Cissé over there.
And Henry, number three, he's gone to the bench. So now you want to put pressure on this guy. He's new. Get up on him. They have a new ball handler in now, so you want to.
Well, they gave it back to Cissé now, so he's going to run it. Cissé coming right side.
Nope.
There's that step back.
Nope.
hits the back of the iron.
Come on.
McCaskey with another rebound. Here we go. Back right side. Now over to Charles Smith.
Oh,
Smith.
No.
Oh, God darn. Golly. Wow.
Well, that's all you can say for that one. Slow down, man. You
almost slipped. Gee Willikers. Cisse in the corner, right side. And they're going to call a foul on Nunley.
They had the possession they needed right then. And, you got to take your time there. Can't rush down there and throw that ball away.
Wow. 3:52 left to play here in this one, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers down 72-63. We've got to do something. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball after these important messages.
Put that on that beat. Shawty made that ass clap, she don't need no applause. High fashion, like Goyard.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen, this Monday, February 5th, starting at 5:30 p.m., more Fast and Furious Southwestern Athletic Conference basketball. As the Panthers take on the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff, great graphic right here in the William Nix Center. I tell you, man, these guys, I keep talking about Woodlawn Entertainment, man, but they are just Johnny on the spot. You know, we haven't really had a production company like this that could do it on the fly like this, so it's just – it's quite refreshing.
Well, you know,
you didn't get to, you know, see, I don't watch Saturday Night Live. It's quite refreshing. Y'all got to watch Saturday Night Live, man. I'm the only zany person here. Is Jamar Young will go to the charity stripe.
Come on.
To shoot free throws, and he'll put that one in there. The disparity here, we can just tell it right now. We're getting killed in the paint. 40-26 in the paint. Yep. You know, 19-31 turnovers. We got 31 turnovers. Our average is 17. We're two over.
Well, you know,
we're not two part. Yeah, I mean, Texas Southern has 31 rebounds to our 19. They're just killing us in the paint, like you said. Yeah, 31-19. Lane for three. No. 3:34 left to play.
Oh,
where's the carrying? Huh? At this point, you don't really – what do you say?
It's only 10, three minutes left.
No, absolutely. You got to stop the ball.
Got to.
See, too much time ticking off right
there. And they brought in back in a primary ball handler.
P.J. Henry.
You got to be kidding me.
Wow. Well, is that going to be it for Smith?
As what?
Is that going to be five on Charles Smith? Yeah, Charles Smith's out of here. That's five. Kevin McCaskey has four. So that's one of our biggest shooters. Now the Tigers. And they're telling what? Whoa. Hey. Yes. Yes. McCaskey with the rebound. We're going back the other way. McCaskey in the corner, gives it up to Lane. Lane thinking about the three. P.J. Henry all over him. He finds a lane, pushes off on him, steps back. And Horton over America, over the way taller 6'11", Jamar Young. He climbs on him and goes back the other way. And Young, they want to watch it. Replay. And golly gee. Boy, we were kind of blown aback by that, weren't we? Ladies and gentlemen, coming up this Monday again, exciting men's action at 7:30, women's action at 5:30. Yep. The Lady Panthers.
Oh, no.
Wanted to leave here 6-3.
No, that's a basket.
That's a basket. No basket. He calls no basket.
Because he grabbed the rim while the ball was in the net.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. Here it is right here. Yeah, they pulled the net down, and the net allowed the ball to fall. So, basket interference, absolutely. Is it called basket interference or just interference? It's net, rim, and pull a net down with it, yeah. So that's interference, and they'll take that one back. The Tigers will have it. 3 minutes left to play. Here comes Henry. Working on Nunley. Nunley, boy, he's going to get it. Nunley. He's going to get a foul. He's too aggressive right now. Sticks his hand in there. Now here comes Cisse with a big dunk to Jamar Young. And Hopkins fouled on our end. And gee whiz. Jamar Young with a big dunk, and the Texas Southern fans love it.
2:24
left to play here in the first. 2:24 left to play in the first.
I'm gonna stop.
And the shot is away. It's good.
Crowd is getting a little excited from that dunk. Right?
Yeah, and they're making their way to the party. Yeah, everybody's.
Oh.
Second shot is away. It's no good. 2:20.
Sit down.
Left
sit down.
To play.
Sit down. Hey, just keep pecking away. I mean, hey.
Henry won't see say.
Worst things have happened. Come on. You can't see you coming.
Up in the front, right side. And they're just playing the clock here. Cisse with the right side. He's got down to 7 seconds. They're going to have to shoot it. Cisse with a double pump, puts it up off the glass. Young puts it up off the glass, and it comes Prairie View way. It goes out on the Tiger.
Is he all right? Man. Brian.
And Miles.
Okay, Miles is okay.
Ball's right there on his back. Well, is anybody going to?
They helped him up.
Okay. I was just our Johnny on the spot sports information crew, or not sports information, sports medicine team, ready to scurry on out there, Coach.
Well, if they run out there, then he has to come out. So
yeah, that's why they will wait. That's why I saw Byron's hand.
That's
behind
our
one, and said, wait.
Our
wait.
One post player. We've been
yeah, we need to. We're going to have to keep him in there.
Oh, man.
Hopkins down to a minute and 50 left to play. Comes right side, McCaskey with a double pump and has it thrown away.
Wow. Make the free throws, man.
Well, Roulette Massey. How you doing? Stacey Frazier watching exciting Panther sports. Amherst. George Amerson. Taisha Lewis. Is that it? Darlene Gross. Hey, Ms. Gross. Jeffrey Jernigan, Mr. Maurice Jackson, my teammate, Dalton Benton.
That's amazing how you know all of these.
Gregory Lee Hazen, hey, what's going on, Bishop? Good. My son Lorenzo, Delphio Esters, hey, sweetie. Paul Stroller, what's going on, my friend?
Wow.
Let's see, Sid Brass, Bebe. Phil Robertson, hey, what's going on, Phil Rob? Come on down for some more softball here. Bring the baby down. Tip, tell Tip we need her to come down for some exciting Panthers softball.
Tell him we need him here Monday night when the basketball game is on.
You know, way in Lamar. They ain't coming down here. They wait. They done had their 5 years of basketball. Well, they played softball. Wide open for three.
Come on. Come on, Lane. Hit me a three right here.
Lane throws it out. He steps and Young comes out and knocks him on the ground there.
Yeah. Come on, get it to him. Pass ahead.
Well.
Wow, come on, Lane, stay up.
Lane shot his way, it's good.
All right. Now hit our free throws.
Down to a minute 10. A 10-point edge, 77-67. 9 points. And reset the clock there, and we're going to spin around. 77-68, a 9-point edge.
Trap that.
Shaquille O'Neal's son, Shakir O'Neal.
Is that who that is?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He's checked into the game for the Tigers.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Okay. Shaq's son.
It's one of Shaq's babies. Yep. Pretty tall. Got a good shot, too.
Man. I got a minute left.
Pardon me?
I said it's a minute. Oh, my goodness.
He's Shaq's son.
That free throw looked like it, that's for sure. He taught him well.
Man, look here. Let me stop, man. Let me stop. Shaquille live in Houston now. You know, we might. You'll be over at Trill Burger or something. And you see this big old hand, come grab you on the shoulder. It'll be too late. Here comes Horton.
I can give him some tips on how to shoot it.
Right side Horton, wide open. Here comes Miles. Miles will stop shooting it up from 15. He's up there, short arm that one, and down to under a minute left to play.
That's not his thing. You know, when you start doing something that's not in your character, you got to do what you do.
Cisse. Throws it left. Here comes O'Neal.
That was a trouble.
And they just want to keep it out of there.
That was a walk. I guess they didn't call it out. Dang.
Kirby. Oh, man. P.J. Henry. He can shoot those long-term shots. And Craig. Chris Craig. Slams it home. Hopkins going towards the bucket. He's going to be fouled. 16 seconds left to play. Man, that's going to do it. Golly gee. Well, folks, Panthers still have an opportunity on Monday to stay up in the standings. Not over by far in conference play. Still got a lot of basketball to play.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, this is
the first round. You know,
the first half. This stops the first half. Exactly. Actually, our first half will stop Monday. Right. Will be our first half. This would normally be the stopping point, but we had a couple of extra days during the ice storm when Pine Bluff had to go home. I don't even think they went home. I think they just stayed around here, didn't they? And left at Tuesday.
Yeah, they did. But I guess due to, just being able to go home, they weren't able to get out of here in a proper manner because the ice was going toward Pine Bluff as well.
Oh, absolutely.
So they felt it would be
bad going that way.
Right. So it was better for them to leave during the daytime and travel instead of waiting until after a game and then be in the evening time, which where the temperature would have went down. So that was the reasoning for playing that.
And the timeout called by Texas Southern here with 9 seconds left to play. 30-second timeout, folks. Exciting Panther basketball continues. This Monday, the women will start their game at 5:30. We'll start a pregame show about 5 o'clock.
Okay.
Right on the splendid network, on our network, the Splendid Media Network, and then we'll pop on over right at about, 5 minutes till. So about 4:25, we'll pop on over, get everything set up, get everything ready.
Well.
And then we'll start out with another win for the women.
Yes.
To get that 6-3, and three, and the men will rebound on Monday, too.
We never got a chance to talk about our game. We did an excellent job hanging in there, holding on to that, you know, the lead that we got in the fourth quarter, and we were able to hang in there. We had some young ladies that played fabulous games.
Well, Jada Roberson, let me just say this. I kind of broke your game down already. Jada Roberson off the bench was huge. Bowen didn't have the minutes that she usually does coming off the bench to do
Bowen.
But I think Williams came off the bench and played well, especially Waddle.
Yes.
Waddle came back and gave you that surge of energy that you needed. Payne, of course, was playing. And you're going to get consistent play from Hutchinson, Soders, and Smith. You know that. They were huge. Smith was huge with 9 rebounds.
Oh, man.
Soders was huge with, 11 rebounds for Soders?
And Payne had 10, 3, 4, and 3.
So,
Don't forget about Ryan Payne.
Well, I was saving the best for last. 10, 4, 11, 3.
But, she's the real deal. So, I just was proud of our team, and we played so well. You know, we won something in a row. But Monday night is going to be a very important contest for us. We got to get that one.
Oh, absolutely. Well, ladies and gentlemen, great basketball for our women's game. The men, not so successful. Tough time here in the William Pitt Center. Lost it by 11, but not for a lack of effort. Man, the Panthers got to put together two halves. Got to put together two whole halves. And, man, we just did not get the games that we needed from some certain players. Miles, you know, had a good game, but Smith fouled out. Just not really in sync like we are usually. So I'm sure we'll get back to the drawing board
Monday night.
We'll see if Coach Smith is not too upset.
Right.
But we know Byron. He don't like to lose at all. Folks, please visit our website at www.pvpanthers.com. Got some interesting things coming up for you. A national signing day, February 7th. Houston, Texas at the Southside Sports Bar, 1110 West Airport Street in Houston. Go on our website and go over to tickets. You can just scroll over the tickets and bring the tickets down. You can pull it if you'd like. And bring the tickets down. To buy tickets there, go to the website, and we'll they'll be able to get some tickets. Also, season tickets are going to go on sale February 7th. Now, I talked to Miss Anitra Addison, who is the ticket person, Coach Evans. Talked to Anitra Addison, and we're going to entertain. There's a possibility that we entertain a payment plan for season tickets. Maybe in two, maybe three payments.
Okay.
So if the season tickets are $500 for all of everything, you can pay it in three increments.
Right,
possibly. Now, don't quote me, folks, because Ms. Addison, I did speak with her, and she said she'll entertain it. That means we'll see if we can do it. I think our system is set up to do that. And Byron is going to come over and talk to us here.
And
thanks a lot, Coach.
Off. All right. We appreciate you. Thank you so much. Thanks for the PV fans.
Hey, man. Thank you. I'm just excited that you were here.
All right. Thank you.
And let's see. Is Byron coming over? That's Byron's daughter over there. Oh, my gosh, she's grown. And we'll sit here and wait for Byron. Stick around. We're going to talk to Byron here for just a second. Give us a break. We'll take a quick break. A quick break and come back with the wrap-up. This is exciting Panther basketball.
We have a lost cell phone here at the scores table. We have a lost cell phone here at the scores table. You can claim it right now, or you can come and get it Monday.
Hey, Don. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life.
For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence, as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter along with head coach Byron Smith. Coach, I felt it way over here. We already looked at it. Rebounding it was a plague. Points in the paint, you know, and we just didn't shoot well today. I don't know what went on with the Panthers. We tried to play our best defense, but, man, just kind of got a little hairy carry today.
Yeah, two guys beat us.
Yeah.
26-25. Let's start there. Two guards. I don't think it was an overall, great team effort necessarily by them. We just couldn't guard those two guys. Just like against Alabama State, T.J. Matlock couldn't guard him.
Yeah. So, some people guards, are on – they're hot. Yeah, those two were hot tonight.
You're only as good as the guards you have. And, obviously in the past we've had great guard play in terms of defending, but tonight we had no answer for those two guys. And, they got away from us for sure.
Well, Coach, we've got a good enough team where we can rebound, get back to the drawing board, get ready for Monday, mm-hmm. and get back to Panther basketball. We're not out of this thing by far. We've got a lot of basketball left to play. Let's just continue to make some adjustments, and that's what good coaches do. And we have all the confidence in you in the world. I mean, I'm gonna paint your car for you for a second. I'm watching you now. You starting to get – you sitting over there with that little look on your face. I'm like, oh, he's thinking about something.
Yeah.
He's going to do something. Yeah. And I think the Panthers can get back on track.
Yeah, I think we can. I think we need to. I think, a lot of basketball left to play. Obviously this is always a tough match. This time last year we were beating them on their home court, mm-hmm. but it's amazing when they win a game. It's like a national championship.
Man, I'm telling you, their fans just love it. I mean, gee whiz.
Last year
we don't want to be any haters.
We don't celebrate enough, I guess, with Prairie View. But, hey, like I say, it's tip my hat to them. They had a nice game plan. They started off really struggling in the non-conference because they played a monstrous, hellacious schedule, but obviously it prepared them for conference play. So they're hot 6-3 to finish out the first half of the conference. We're 3-5 right now with one to go. Hopefully we can be 4-5 by Monday night and get ready for the second half of conference.
All right, Coach. Well, I know you got to get back to your guys and to the drawing board. Just keep on grinding, Coach. We're behind you 100%. We know the Panthers can bounce back. We've just got to make a couple of adjustments, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget, exciting Panther basketball returns this Monday as the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff come to town to take on the Panthers. Should be a great game. The pregame show will start right there on Splendid Media at around 5 o'clock, 5:30 tip-off for the women. At 7:30, tip-off for the men. Coach, your final words on the night's game?
Hey, man, thanks, everybody, for coming out. Great crowd tonight, man. Really, really raucous crowd. And we should have had a little bit better play with the inspiration that we have from the crowd. So hopefully we can get a similar crowd on. Probably won't be as good, but maybe something 75%.
I think they'll come back out for Monday. I'm really thinking that they're going to come back out for Monday because the students have been huge for the Panthers.
Yep. Absolutely.
That's going to wrap it up for us here. Thanks a lot, Coach, tonight for Woodlawn Entertainment. James Crenshaw, his crew, they do a great job. Our athletic director, Mr. Anton Gall. Our senior women administrator, Miss Alicia Pete. This has been Charles Porter, along with Mia Greer, the entire Panther Sports Broadcast team, and our sports information and our great social media team over there. Saying so long. We'll see you on Monday with more exciting Panther basketball. Good night.